the meeting.
Good day. Please allow us to fully read our presentation, because otherwise we will not be able to fit the 15 minutes time frame. So, the fortified settlement in Albești, Constanța County, was the subject of a monography published in 2008. The main stages in the fort construction and evolution have been settled back then. The general historical background during the 4th and 3rd centuries BC, with its possible implications in the settlement's evolution, as well as the relations between the colony, Calatis, and its territory during the mentioned period. The archaeological campaigns in the last decade have especially dealt with the extended area of the fortification towards south, sector A, since the intramural space was increased in the third stage of its existence. During this same stage, the area outside the walls continues to be inhabited as an open settlement. The extramuros housing close to the southern wall of the fortification features large rectangular parallel units, better consolidated than the similar ones situated in the southern intramuros area. The archaeological inventory recovered from these campaigns, especially ceramic items, are dated to the mid-4th century, late 3rd century BC. We mention in chronological order amphora stems from Heracleea Pontica, Thasos, Sinope, Rhodos. Other identified centers, Acanthos, Paros, Kos, and possibly Cnidos, paint the complete picture of amphora imports at Albești without causing any changes in general chronology of the settlement. The analyzed material comes from housing units situated in Sector A, the majority, Sector C, Sector D, and an excavation trench perpendicular to the outer face of the southern fortification wall. The total number of collected items is 110. Their presentation, grouped on production centers, is a chronological one and also selective at the same time. The selection targets novelties, may it be new names or new content versions for the stems coming from already known centers, listed above, or typologies and possible new production centers for the ceramic packages. Heracleea Pontica stems, in total of 21 items. Amongst the magistrate stems, Andronikos and Peisistratos are new names for Albești. The last one, hypothetical restitution on a stamp with a retrograde inscription. Two new combinations in Albești are notable. Magistrate Luciteos, combined with fabricants Kokos and Malakon. The fabricant's name Kokos is less known. A fabricant with this name is mentioned by Grakov and in LGPN 5A, and also appears on an anglyphic stamp at Albești. This one. In the short version of the name, Koko, and discovery context leads us to include the name in the early fabricants group. This new combination, Kokos Lusiteos, confirms the presence of a fabricant named Kokos amongst the Heracleea stems. The large time span between the early fabricants group and magistrates group MG3B, of which Lusiteos is part of, could suggest the existence of two homonyms. Thasos. Of the seven newly discovered items coming from Thasos, the new eponyms names from Albești are Prexipolis, Demalches, and Diagoras, each of them with several appearances in Calatis as well. All of them are written with lunar sigmas. The stamp of Demalches, accompanied by the flying bird emblem, represents a product of Vamburi Amudia workshop, and that of Prexipolis with a sword in scabbard emblem, a product of the workshop in Chioni. Sinope stamps are more numerous, as it usually happens in Albești. 71 items were found, of which the majority, 44, attributed to group 6 after Garlan. The earliest is a first group stamp bearing the emblem vulture on a dolphin. It is used in the early years of Sinopean stamps. The only emblem of this type amongst those found in Albești was printed on a stamp with the name Menalches, subgroup 1b. In our case as well, we are probably facing an astronom name from subgroup 1b or 1c. Newly attested astronoms in Albești are Epielpes I with fabricant Teuteras, Atalos, Hecataios I, and Demetrios II, all from group 5a. The newly discovered stems complete the contents of subgroup 5a at Albești, Aeschines IV being now the only name missing here. From subgroup 6b, we mentioned too much rare appearances. Antipatros without a patronym, on a three-line stems, and the name of fabricant Mitredates written with epsilon on a stamp of Antipatros I Nikonos. Of subgroup 6C1, two astinomes are to be found on stems from Albești. Antesterios Numeniu, 4 items, and Hecataius II Artemidorum. The first astinome is well known in Histia and Odessus. The absence of these two astinomes in Calatis, though, makes its involvement in the diffusion of these products in its territory less plausible. Among fabricant stamps, two names can be mentioned, Heracleides and Philon. In the first case, the fabricant is probably Heracleides III, known on the amphoras of astinomes in subgroup 5C. The second fabricant name, Philon, can be seen on a two lines retrograde stamp. This one can be Philon II, whose activity can be placed at the end of group 4 and in group 5B and C. The Rhodos imports are represented at Albești by 8 stamps. New variants of the names known for the first Albești catalogue appear here. New eponym names are Polycles, Aeschylinos, and Testor. From a chronological point of view, Polycles is part of the series of eponyms known from workshop in Hisarenu and is part of Finkelstein period 1b, 270-247 BC, or in a smaller time frame, somewhere between 262-247 BC. In Badu's ranking from 2015, Polycles would rather be dated around 255 BC. The eponym Aeschylinos is part of the period 2b in its early years. The eponym Testor must be mentioned as part of period 2a, dated approximately to 192 BC. This is the only eponym belonging to the third period which has been attested at Albești, and its presence here sets the date for the termination of amphora imports to the end of the first decade of the second century BC. Amongst the fabricant stamps, the only new name appearing is Menon the Second. Menon the Second stamps depict eponyms from periods 2c and 3a. The arched shape of the handle lead us to believe that it can be dated to period 2c. Lastly, we also need to mention the name of Theodoros, interleaved with the month Panamos Deuteros. It is restituted based on an item from Olbia Lower City. The name is considered to be that of the Rhodian fabricant who was active in periods 1c and 2. From our point of view, Theodoros II is the eponym from period 2c because the name is written in nominative, making the use of the AP preposition unnecessary. Having this in mind, Theodoros would fit in the series of new eponyms attested at Albești. Items from other amphora production centers like Paros, Akantos, and Knidos have been recently discovered as well in small numbers and fit within the limits set by the first catalog. Now for the amphora containers. The newly found amphorae belong to the already known production centers. In the same order as in the first catalog, we need to mention amphorae from Heracleea Pontica, Thasos, Sinope, Rhodos, Knidos, and Kos. Amongst amphorae of other origins, found in smaller numbers, of which could not be assigned to a production center, we find the Peparetus Nec, Soloha 2, two toes of Chios amphorae, and some dietral mushroom type. Two amphorae discovered in 2019 of unusual shape and size can also be mentioned here. Item A69, published in the Albești monograph in 2008, as part of amphorae with other origin category, needs to be particularly evoked again. In the meantime, this item has been acknowledged as Erythrea amphora of type 4, according to Monahov, and dated to the late 4th century BC, first decade of the 3rd century BC. Coming back to the newly found containers, we will describe them grouped by their production centers ordered as in the first catalog. For Heracleea Pontica, we mentioned the lower part of a conical shaped amphora. The container shape and maximum diameter are similar to type 2-1 according to Monahov 2003, dated to the second and third quarter of the 4th century BC. This artifact was discovered in the same context as two Heraclean stamps from group MG3A, dated to the mid 4th century. Three amphora necks are also worth mentioning. Two, found together with a number of stamps coming from Heracleea Pontica, part of the late fabricants group series, one of which shows a dipinti with letters with the letters eta rho in a ligature. The third item can be placed among the type 2-1 amphorae as well. From the Sinope group, we need to mention two fragments belonging to conical-shaped amphorae, which we place amongst types 2-3A and 3B, according to Monahoff 2003. The first container is dated to the last quarter of the 4th century, early 3rd century BC, and its shape can be found on Monahoff 2003. For the second item, we feel that category 3B, according to Monahoff, is more appropriate, judging by the container found in the Museum of Chersones, dated to the 3rd quarter of the 3rd century BC. From the same category of Sinope amphorae, we need to mention the following items. The upper part of an amphora, its handles do not show any stems. By its dimensions, we place this fragment in type 2D, dated between the mid-4th century and mid-3rd century BC. Neck fragment, probably belonging to an amphora of type 3C2, belonging to the 3rd quarter of the 3rd century BC. Neck and stem handle of an amphora. This could belong to a container of type 3A, judging by the items found in the museum in Chersones. This type is dated to the second half of the 3rd century. The handle is marked with the stamp of 6D Garland Group Astinom, Iphis the 3rd Hestiaiu, and Fabrican Artemon. The products of Rhodos are represented by a fragmentary amphora with long cylindrical neck, ovoid body, and arched unstamped handles. The container belongs to the early Rhodian amphora type, as stated by Villanova, or type 1E1, according to Monahoff 2003, and is dated to the mid-3rd century and second half of the same century BC. This amphora has been found in the same context as two Rhodian stamps with buttons belonging to period 1B and the third Rhodian stamp belonging to period 2A, so 234-220 BC. Amongst the amphorae of various origins, we must mention the following. Peparetos amphora neck, Soroha 2, with a deep inky painted in red, letter B. Analogies to be found at Monahoff 2003, type 1B, dated between the middle of the 3rd quarter of the 4th century, or 340-320 BC, judging by the container from the collections of Chersones Museum. Chios amphora toe, of conical shape and concave on the inside, belonging to type 5B, according to Monahoff 2003, dated between the 1st and the 3rd quarters of the 4th century BC. Fragments of the neck and lip of a pink amphora, made out of dense clay with a yellow slip on the outside. The flaring of the lip and circular section of the handle lead us to believe we are dealing with an Eritrea amphora of type 2A, Monahoff 2012, dated to the 3rd quarter of the 4th century BC. The last two amphorae discovered in 2019 raise a series of questions related to their typology and assignment. The first one shows characteristics specific to the ones coming from Sinope, having a conical body with rounded toe and a specific clay appearance, beige-orange, with lots of small black particles. This shape can be found at Zest and at Monahoff 2003, late variant 3A, both being dated around the second half of the 3rd century BC. Its maximum diameter is closer to the type 2 items. A restored amphora with an indefinite production center and no analogy is depicted at Monahoff 1999. The amphora, which is missing its toe, is executed in red clay. According to the author quoted earlier, the item is similar to the Sinopean amphora of type 2. Comparing the two items, we can see that the amphora found at Albești has an elongated profile and a toe specific to the Sinopean containers. The complex in which this item was found is dated to the first two decades of the 3rd century BC. At Albești, the amphora was found close to a hearth, which is placed on a layer of earth and stone and is protected on its southern and western sides by stone. The archaeological material found in this section, in a layer of debris, consists of fragments of Rhodian, Sinopean, and amphorae, and maybe of Cossian origins, as well as fragments of jetic pottery. A funnel-shaped Lekitos neck, belonging to the type dated at Albești to the 3rd century BC, was found on top of the hearth, along with a bowl bottom with repairing traces. The mentioned amphora wasn't found in a layer of debris, but in an archaeological level specific to the 3rd century BC, and we are inclined to consider it of Sinopean origin. The second item we will discuss is another large amphora, but of a different type than the other ones. Its asymmetrical body is large and leans on a cylindrical 7 centimeters high toe. Its brick-colored clay shows many inclusions of different sizes. Elements which would allow us to fit it in a certain type do not exist. We are talking about the upper part of the container which is missing. The only part available is the mounting point of one of its handles. The amphora was found in a filling layer consisting of dark earth mixed with small rocks and rare ceramic fragments. The archaeological inventory found in the same place on the compacted level is poor, showing some fragments of a Thasian toe and Rhodian amphora fragments. The only resemblance regarding the amphora's toe that we can think of is Gray's Amperer 1981 as an unpublished item from the deposits of the Greek-Roman Museum in Alexandria. The toe on this amphora is 16 centimeters high. It was identified by comparing its handles as an amphora of Donax group Petos in Egypt. It is considered to be a Greek type amphora dated to the 2nd century BC. Now a few conclusions. Stamps as well as amphora containers newly discovered support the same percentage ratio for the centers well documented in Albești so far. Ordered by their frequency, they are Sinope, Heracleea Pontica, Rhodos, and Thasos. The general data for each center regarding circulation periods or maximum occurrence of imports in Albești is not changed by the new discoveries. Some remarks regarding these new materials refer to the lack of early Heracleea Pontica stamps, a more powerful occurrence of two named stamps in groups MG3 and MG2 after Katz, or D and F after Balabanov, Garlan, and Avram, the lack of early Thasian stamps, the two named type, the poor representation of Sinopean stamps from the first chronological groups. Rhodian stamps found here can be included in periods 1b and 1c. However, we find indication that Rhodian imports at Albești continued throughout the first decade of the 2nd century BC, up to 292 BC. These items complement the series of imports from already known production centers and fit into the typologies common to the Pontic area. The newly discovered shapes can represent either new variants of some already known types or new types of a production center located most probably in the Pontic area. The data provided by the newly discovered items does not change, but only complements our prior remarks about the existence and evolution of the settlement at Albești in the time frame between the mid 4th century BC and late 3rd century BC, with possible prolongation to the first decades of the 2nd century BC. Thank you for your attention.